Good morning, everyone. Good Devach, Shavua Tov. We are continuing, Baruch Hashem, after a long, beautiful Yom Tiv, Shoshana, Yom Kippur, Sukkot, Simchas Torah, continuing in doing something that's going to keep us on our mahalich, on our pathway, which is learning halacha, which is the pathway of Jewish life. And we left off in the laws of Kiddush, and we continue with very important halachas and laws, which will enhance our Shabbos table, hopefully to enhance the Yom Tov table a bit, but we'll continue with our daily learning. HaChalos, Yiyu Mechusim B'Shas Kiddush. There is a mitzvah that we have, that during the time that one is making Kiddush, we are supposed to keep the challah covered. Now, what is the reason for this? So basically, we spoke about previously that normally the order of significance of brachas would be that you would make a bracha hamotzi lechem min ha'aretz on the bread before you would make the bracha b'ripi ha'gofen on the wine. And however, on Shabbos, when we make Kiddush first, which means that we're making the bracha on the wine before we make the bracha on the bread, so we need to cover the challah first in order, as we said, not to bring embarrassment and shame to the bread. Normally, we make a bracha on the bread first, and now we're overlooking the bread to make the wine. It has a concept of an embarrassment to the bread that we keep making it secondary, and therefore, we're going to cover up the bread as if it's not there at the time of Kiddush, and therefore, the wine is the first bracha that should be made. So therefore, we say, the challah is the bread, so the challah should be covered at the time of Kiddush. Even if you're making Kiddush on bread, if a person doesn't have wine, they don't have grape juice, they don't have another drink that they can use to make Kiddush, so they have to make Kiddush on challah. If you look inside of your siddur or your bencher that you use, you'll see how you can do that. Even there, a person is going to keep the challahs covered. Now, what's the reason for that? The reason is, mechusim b'shas ha-kiddush, so, since one of the reasons that we have two challahs on Friday night and Shabbos day, and even by Challos is the meal that we have in the third meal, is because we know that the challah is to remind us of the man, the special bread that fell down from the heavens while the Jewish people were wandering through the desert for 40 years. And every day of the week, only enough man that you needed to eat for that day would fall. So one loaf of bread would fall, and that would satisfy you for the entire day. On Shabbos, the man would not fall from the heavens. That means that on Friday, a double portion of man would fall, and it would be saved for, one portion would be saved for the following day, one for Friday night, and one for Shabbos day. So the challah that we eat on Shabbos is to remind us of the miracles of the man that fell in the wilderness. And therefore, what does that have to do with covering it? Shai mechusa betal milamata ulamala. One of the ways that Hashem preserved the man in the wilderness was that there was a covering of dew that surrounded the man on top, and there was a covering of dew that surrounded the man on the bottom as well. And therefore, since that the challah reminds us of the man, the miraculous bread that fell in the wilderness, so even if you're making Kiddush only on the bread because you don't have any wine, still it has to be covered, because that is part of the zeich l'man, to remind us of the man that fell. And therefore, you have the challah covering on top, and if you can wrap it around the bottom when you hold it up to make the bracha, that will be good. And if your challah covering is not big enough to cover the bottom, so then we say the fact that there's a challah board that's on the bottom that you are lifting up the challah from, that will count as the covering for the bottom, and as it is as if your bread is wrapped in on top and on the bottom to remind us of the dew that encapsulated the man in the wilderness. Okay, that's the halacha today. Be'ez Hashem, we shall continue tomorrow. Have a wonderful day.